Hello, I am FrAvatar. Welcome to a brand new Let's Play of Frostpunk 2. I've never played Frostpunk or Frostpunk 2, but we're gonna get going. I do have Frostpunk 1, and I might play it on the channel at some point, but I've been watching people play this one recently, and I wanted to give it a go too. We're gonna play on hardest difficulty, but not Survivor mode, because Survivor mode has no pause. Once we beat the story on Captain, we might go for a Utopia run or whatever it's called, and we'll play with Survivor mode. But yeah, 1887 city builder, where it's more like steampunk, and the world froze over. There's gonna be a cinematic.
Captain! Can you hear us?
Captain!
Do you hear us?
A generation ago, we fled the crumbling British Empire as the world froze around us. I held New London together, united. We survived 30 years of whiteouts. But the world around us is dead.
Merely surviving is not enough. We have to expand. After all, it's us who survived the end of the world.
Yes. Now what?
So, murdered by freezing. Old man got murdered by freezing. So now there's a change of command. All right, so we get to play the prologue. We must survive. We've been roaming the frozen desert for years. Many of us do not remember a world before the great frost. Now another whiteout is coming, and again we've reached the old machine. Again we will rely on its furnace to provide heat through the storm. In the past, we always made sure there were enough supplies for the next whiteout. But our numbers have grown through the years, providing for everyone is getting harder and harder. Well, we must survive. So everything's under ice. We're gonna have to crack the ice to get to everything. First things first, prologue for the Wanderers. We're going to fight the cold. The old dreadnought remains in pieces under layers of snow, but the scattered wagons still have resources inside. First, we must break ice to reach one of the oil wagons and construct an extraction district to use it. Then we can turn on the dreadnought's furnace to heat us. We will restart the furnace. Pause. Okay, first off, we need to crack some ice. Let's do it this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six, I guess. Oh, wait. 7. Eight. Sure. Then we need to crack some more ice. Then we need to build some housing. So there's a heat bonus from having 3 tiles of the 6 housing districts. We'll get a +3 heat bonus. Then we're gonna go here. Here. Sure. All right, that should do it. You can see the Frostbreakers out at work. This is where we're going to do the first thing that's going to make them not like us much. We're going to tax them. Thank you. sure. Like that, I guess. Something like that. Yeah, it's cold. Sure, like that. Right, faster, I guess.
Okay.
more shelter. More wreckages. Yeah, okay. Something like that. Gain access to food. Yeah, I'm doing that right now. Getting there. Thank you. woods shelter. We must prepare. We're not stockpiling. Well, we're getting there. Something like that. The mysterious symbol, the captain's legacy. One of our frost-breaking crews uncovered the frozen remains of a man in a tattered uniform. His shoulder patch reads, New London Scouts 3rd Platoon, and he bears an obscure insignia. Some of our elders claim it belongs to a military organization, while others argue it's a religious significance. Maybe you ever heard of this New London before, and we can settle their debate. It's either order or fate, or I don't recognize, and one will randomly be picked. Let's say order for this run. Okay, hold up. Not quite enough to build more. Break because I see it coming. We need a food depot. Yeah, you're right. We need two food depots. We need one. We need more prefabs. Okay, 80. Okay, and you don't need to be overdriving anymore. Need to sacrifice anybody for food. Don't worry. order emergency shift, sure. Now we need more food. More workforce. Okay, hold up. So far, so good. Okay, hold up. I would very much like to get that last one down here. And this maintenance wagon here. But we just don't have the population to run everything, right? Hold up, we might have a problem here, right? Because if this calculation is taking into consideration that this runs the whole time,
Thank you.
Whiteout draws near a sacrifice? No, we won't need to. We will gather enough food in time. We'll be fine. Can we rush this? Workforce, hold up. Right. 150 workforce. How many do I have? Zero? Hold up. Almost there. Yes. Also, can I put in more? I need 80 more prefabs and I have 63. Go. Now we can load balance this. Okay. Excellent. Everything's in the positive. Now, we should be able to put one last stockpile, and I guess we'll put it... Oh, look how unfortunate that placement is. Alright, here. Yeah, here. Food secure. We did it. We secured enough food to survive the incoming whiteout. Our workers will make some last minute preparation before the storm arrives, trying to keep our people safe and warm. We will survive. Now we wait. Okay. Can we do more ice breaking? No. Go. Oh, I could return your scraps. one day. Yeah, we're gonna be fine. And the whiteout is here. Against all odds, Wanderer's survival. Whiteout hit the camps, the Wanderers were ready. Everyone was thankful we acted fast and gathered enough food in time. Miracle Seal Colony striking our hope. Journey will lead to the Promised Land. Elders added the story to our great tales, alongside warning, sinful city still pumps smoke into the sky. Alright, we survived. And unless I'm mistaken, with zero losses? Nobody died? Alright, good job, me. Alright, we survived. We survived the end of the world. Now what? Then, New London is weak. Food is low, overpopulation looms, coal is running out. People yearn for a future worth dreaming of, but is it the same future for all? Keep the city together. Or hold its hand on its deathbed. Chapter 1, Scraping the Barrel. Coal is running out. Alright, and I think this is a good spot to end the first episode. Captain is dead. As he weakened, growing division brought city maintenance to a grinding halt. Now New London is left to suffer consequences. As steward, it is your charge to lead, but you must prove yourself. The overcrowded city is low on resources. You use this warmer year to build more shelter, secure coal and power the generator back on. Let's get to work. Alright, yeah, like I said, long enough for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. We'll see you in the next one. In the meantime, take care. Bye-bye.